Tommy Edison is a successful radio reporter. Tommy is also blind. For Tommy, it's determination, not his disability, that makes the difference.
Toward Darien and Stanford Center down to exit 8. Better ride through Greenwich down toward the state line. Trains are good. The next star 99.9 dependable traffic when you need it.
For the last 2 years, popular Connecticut radio personality Tommy Edison has been visiting schools with his on-air partners, John Harper and Lisa Wiernik. They talk to kids about their careers in radio, but their presentation offers something more than the usual show and tell. Tommy, who is the radio station's traffic reporter, also has a disability. Tommy is blind.
I never really met too many blind people when I was a kid, you know, or I met kids my own age. I never met somebody who was older than me and had a job and was working and living on their own. I want to try and help out kids, you know. I wish somebody was helping me out when I was a kid and telling me that you can do this, you can do whatever you want to do.
Tommy grew up in Greenwich and attended both public and private schools, but never schools for the blind. His was a warm and supportive family, giving Tommy a will to succeed and a refusal to accept defeats.
I grew up in a family that, you know, was pretty cool about things. You know, kids were learning how to ride bikes and stuff. My parents encouraged me to try it as well.
His family's attitude bolstered Tommy's own determination. What Tommy was determined to do was be on the radio.
Ever since I was a little kid, I mean, I always had a radio. I don't ever remember myself not having one. I just liked the music, you know, and I liked the guys who were playing the records, and they were always having a great time. And I knew that's what I wanted to do. I wanted to have a good time like them.
After college, Tommy got an internship at a small AM station in Stamford. Tommy read the weather and live commercials. Several radio jobs followed until 50,000-watt Star 99.9 FM beckoned. They needed a traffic reporter for their morning team, and they wanted Tommy. Working several phones and police scanners, Tommy uses his ears to gather traffic information. He soon became an indispensable part of the morning team.
The three of us operate as one person now, on the radio and off the radio. It's like we share a brain, and I think Tommy has empowered all of us to take a look at ourselves and say, yeah, we can do that, we can accomplish that.
For several years, John Harper had been visiting schools to share the world of radio. After working with Tommy, it occurred to John that he could add another dimension to the kids' understanding of the radio business.
In my job, there's nothing to see.
The classroom visits, which the team calls their School-a-Palooza tour, enables kids to enter Tommy's world. It allows them to think about the blind and themselves in a new way.
And when we do walk in there, kids stare at him and don't understand. And sure, something curious you're going to look at, but I think he does a great job of immediately taking them under his arm.
And it's usually the first time that they have seen someone handicapped up close, and we show them how Tommy gets around. So it's a learning experience for them, and by the end of the session, they just say, well, he's no different than me.
You guys like lima beans?
No.
Tommy, you like lima beans?
Negatory on those lima beans.
So what's the difference?
Nothing.
And they asked some of the most wonderful questions. One kid one time asked me, when you were first learning how to walk, did you have a little tiny cane to learn how to walk with?
Did people make fun of you? Did you ever meet anyone else who was blind and became friends with them?
When you go to restaurants and stuff on your own, how do you know what's on the menu?
Well, McDonald's always has the same thing all the time.
On one of the morning team school visits, Tommy met fifth grader Danny Nichols. Danny is a radio fan who, like Tommy, is blind and attends a regular school. Letters were exchanged and a valuable friendship ensued.
I think that Mr. Edison's a real inspiration and really gives Danny a lot to think about. If you feel that you can, get up and do it.
We have a lot of stuff in common. I never knew blind people could do that. I thought you just had, to see, to do a traffic report. I think it teaches people about, don't feel down about your life if you're blind.
After meeting Tommy, people realize we're more the same than we are different.
I think he's got a heart of gold for people. He's just got it in his blood to seek out and show people that anyone can do whatever they set their mind to.
Again, it comes down to you got to want it badly enough, but you can do whatever you want to do. I tended to feel the victim, you know, why me? There's so many other people on the planet, you know, why does it have to be me? But rather than be a victim, you have to take what you're given and make something positive out of it. If I can help, that's fabulous.